I've been here for about 13 months, 14 months.
So are you in your second year?
Yes, second year.
Yes. Or an MBA. Are you getting an MBA, right? Or
yes, I'm doing MBA.
Excellent. And do you like it? What do you like about it, I should say?
Okay. First of all, I like that the concept that we are, they're trying to teach us how to become a leader, business leader.
Good.
That's very good. That's very important for me and for my country because we have a vacuum of leadership over there in Egypt. We need someone, some people who can understand how to become a leader and to lead the people over there and the organization and especially the government organization to do the right thing.
That's right. Well said.
So how do you think an MBA will help you if you go back or when you go back to Egypt, how do you think the MBA will help you?
Look, I think I have a specific, I'm assigned to specific task because I work in the Ministry of Health, Egyptian Ministry of Health, and we are a group of MDs who came here to study MBA healthcare management to go back to the Egyptian Ministry of Health and try to do something better than what is going right now. So I think when I go back to Egypt, I will be able at least to understand how to identify the problems, how to identify the solution, and how to engage people in this solution.
And that's part of the leadership training that you're getting.
And yeah.
That's the most important thing. We learn something about finance and accounting and everything, but the most important is how to build competitive advantage for whatever you do and to engage people on the same track to work with you.
Right.
And certainly right now with what's called Obamacare, the new healthcare reform law, right now the U.S.
Yeah.
is you know, working with the healthcare system to find efficiencies. And
I think I was lucky because I came here during this period of debate. There is a lot of debate about Obamacare, and especially last summer I had an introduction healthcare class. And there was a Supreme Court judge decision about the Obamacare.
Oh, that's right.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes, last
year. There was a lot of debate about this decision in the classroom, and that was very enriching for me and for my experience.
It's learning from what goes on right now. You're living history, as we say.
It is some sort of real experience.
Right.
Not just...
Were you surprised by the when it was Chief Justice Roberts cast the deciding vote, and he found that the law, that what they call the individual mandate, the requirement to buy health insurance, that it was constitutional, which you know, that was the big question. How was were they going to decide? Were you surprised by the decision?
What I was what?
Were you surprised by the ruling?
I am with Obamacare, so I am not surprised. I was wishing that it would be, because you know that we are from a collective country, a collective society, and we tend to accept the social and the more collective and the social thing is more than the focusing on individualized thing.
Yes.
I think this will benefit the public overall, but it may hurt some people, some businesses, but overall I think it will get benefit for the overall people. Because I have about 40 million people, 45 million people uninsured.
Right. In the U.S., right.
And that drives the cost very high, and you have to do something about this. And maybe some people, the premium for some people will go high a bit later, but at least the whole overall cost will go down. I hope so.
Abu, I think you said that you were with a health group from your government that came over. A lot more came over to take classes.
We are about seven in the Akron, Ohio.
Why Akron?
Akron.
Why Akron, Ohio?
Why Akron, Ohio? Because Northeast Ohio is very good in healthcare. You have Cleveland Clinic, some health organization. Okay. And some people went to, I think, Texas. Texas also have some.
Texas and Ohio. I didn't know that.
Well, I laughed because, well, you know, Carolyn went to the University of Akron.
That's
so
my alma mater.
When she asked why
I Akron. I heard you telling my wife that you went to Gazetta Hall.
Gazetta Hall, right?
Yeah, Gazetta Hall. I know it. I have been there once. There was a band over there, and I went to listen to the music. But the problem is that this band started to talk about business later on. After they did their performance, they started to talk about leadership and business, and they changed the music part to the business part.
One was good, one not.
Well, it's been a pleasure talking to you, and we hope to. So, are you a doctor? You said you were a doctor.
Yeah.
You're an MD,
yes.
Medical doctor.
And you know what else? He's also a Zip.
Oh, Zip.
A Zip, right? University of Akron Zip. That's your name. Your mascot.
What is a Zip?
Zips. They call every alumni of Akron Zips. As the team of Akron are a group of Zips. And we encourage them in basketball, saying, go Zips, go Zips.
Do you know the history of that?
No.
The mascot is actually a kangaroo. I don't know how
I know
it.
That.
I don't know how it got to be a kangaroo, but the Zip goes back to the Goodyear Rubber Company, which is located in Akron. They developed the first boots that had zippers on them, rubber boots. And so that's how Akron got the title Akron Zips. There you go.
Cool.
Now you can tell your friends, your colleagues at Akron University.
I do, because we are interested about this, and we were concerned a little about what's the relation between the mascot, the kangaroo, and the Zips.
There, now you know the story.
Now I know that's. Yeah.